What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabid here, and today we're taking a look at this guy right here, the ColEngine P2-X, which actually is formerly known as the Superscalar K10 Plus. So I did show you guys how to set this up previously. Check that video in the description if you got one and you want to know how to set this up, as well as a link to the K10 tool, which is in English. I do have that hosted on my website because somehow that did disappear. So all that information will be available in the description area. And if you haven't yet, be sure to hit that subscribe button and hit that thumbs up, because it's all about going to the moon on the Rabid Mining channel. All right, so I'm sure a lot of you guys have heard of the K10 before, the Superscalar there. So this is actually a smaller, more compact, and it deals with heating issues I guess the K10 originally had. So I have not had any heating issues with this one. It does run fairly cool, never has a shutdown. Everything has been going pretty smooth. Now, we're gonna go through some things here about the algorithms of mine. I'll go through all my testing here. I did test all the algorithms. To keep in mind though, Ironfish, it forked, can no longer be mined on this machine. Alethium still can be mined on this machine, but as we all know, that will soon be very heavy into ASICs, so these will fall off as well. But Superscalar is very good on bitstreams. They're fast to implement new coins, and I do assume that a lot of new coins will be coming very soon for this miner. So the first major thing I would definitely want to point out here is this is a pretty loud miner. I am yelling into my microphone right now, but it does have a lot of background distribution. It kind of silences the background, so I'm not sure if you guys can even hear this miner, but it's very loud. So I'm actually going to turn my mic around and use my decibel meter here, and then you guys can hear it. So you might want to turn your volume down. Like I said, this thing does background noise cancellation very well, so it might get very loud. So a fair warning as we check the decibels in 3, 2, 1. Alright, so let me know down in the comment section how that sounded, but we could see that that thing went over 100 decibels. 101 to 103 decibels is what this thing was screaming at. So it is not a quiet miner. If you're in an apartment or something, you're definitely going to be waking up your neighbors and probably get evicted or something. No, we'll see what happens there. I don't live in an apartment and I highly doubt it. You're also going to need 200 volt plus to run the power supply it comes with. Now, you could probably find, you know, something around 2000 watts or something that runs at 120 volt, but you're obviously going to need a big enough 120 volt breaker to run that high amount of power, something in the 20 to 25 amp range, because you do want to remain at 80%. But, you know, 200 volt plus based on that, as well as over 100 decibels, this is not designed for the average home miner. All right, so for the current supported algorithms, this does mine Alethium, Radiant, Carlson, Nexella, as well as NTL, and I do believe Pyron Hash will be coming soon as well as some other coins, possibly Gram, the new Gram coin as well that's on Ton is going to be getting FPGA support as well. So those are all going to be coming, and more will be coming in the future. As for the hash rates it's reported to get, and again, this is all coming in from Jingle Mining. They did send me out this miner to showcase for you guys here. I do love this miner personally because it is an FPGAs, and FPGAs are awesome for coins that are about to transition to ASICs. You get that middle ground in there, and they can make quite a bit of money if you hit the coins at the right time. And Superscalar getting bit streams out really fast, you know, that is a plus side for these type of machines here. Now, one thing I do want to point out here is when I did the power testing here is I let it run for 2 or 3 days, and then I shut everything off that I have here, all the Kaspa ASICs, GPUs if they're on, CPU mining rigs, and then I tested the power. That way it was all heated up and ready to go so we could see the long-term effects on the power. But as for what it's reported to do, and links down in the description if you're looking for one of these with code RabidMining is 1% off, it does say 37.13 gigahash at 1458 watts for Alethium. Radiant is 22.28 gigahash at 1236 watts. Carlson is 32.08 gigahash at 1484 watts. Nextel is 32.08. It's the same algorithm, so it makes sense there. For 1484 watts again, and then NTL is the same at 32.08 gigahash and 1484 watts. So after I tested this, I'm going to compare that to the numbers here. Let's jump into my workstation and see what my hash rates and power consumptions actually look like. All right, so here is my real world testing results with the dev fee and everything. I do believe the dev fee is about 10 or 15%. I'm leaning more to the 15% side of things. That does seem where most of these dev fees are for a lot of coins on any FPGA miner. And Carlson hash starting off here, 24 hours at least on the pool for an average and at the wall power by itself. Carlson hash is NTL, that's your Nextel as well, and you know, Carlson and all them coins based on this algorithm. My average hash rate was 33.5 gigahash at 1340 watts. So that's actually less than what is being reported on the Jingle Mining website. Alephium, which is in yellow here, is going to be gone soon due to the fact that ASICs is not going to be make it worthwhile to mine on an FPGA anymore. But we were about 38.97 gigahash at 1294 watts. Ironfish, which is red, so there's not really a point in looking to it anymore, but it was 306 gigahash at only 1252 watts. And Radiant, which is still available to mine and probably always will be unless an ASIC comes eventually, 23.04 gigahash at 1106 watts. Now the interesting thing here is Radiant on other FPGAs did seem to use more power, where this one is actually the least amount of power out of all of these FPGA coins. So I thought that was interesting on this miner, or I just can't remember my past tests previously. So it doesn't take very long to get to the numbers there, but it did take me almost 2 weeks at 3 days per algorithm to really test this miner. So keep that in mind. You know, it doesn't take forever to get to those numbers here, but as for this miner in particular, I do feel that this is probably one of the best price to performance FPGAs that you can get. You're getting a lot of hash rate here at around $4,000, $4,500 or something is what Jingle Mining has. So again, if you do want an FPGA miner and it's something you've been waiting to try and try out for yourself, be sure to use them links down in the description, and code RabidMining is 1% off. So that's pretty much the rundown on this miner. It didn't take very much to get to the bottom line of them numbers, but I do have to send this one away very, very soon. I do believe it's going to be sending out to Voscoin here, so he's going to be showing a lot more people because he's sitting over 500,000 subscribers or something. So a lot of people are going to get their eyes on this miner soon. So it's hard to say what stock will be like. So if you are looking for an FPGA miner, they might not last once Voscoin gets his word out. So thank you for checking out this video. I will see you on the next one. Rabid out.